continued with the spinal cord. As we have finished with the external features, today we will do the internal features of the spinal cord. As you know, every part of the nervous system is made up of the gray matter and the white matter. So in order to see the gray matter and the white matter, we have to cut the spinal cord to see the internal structures. And to see the internal structure, we take the transverse section of the spinal cord at mid thoracic level. Because it gives a better view of the white matter as well as the gray matter. So when we cut the transverse section of the spinal cord, we see that gray matter lies inside and the white matter lies outside the gray matter, and the gray matter resembles alphabetically H-shaped structure. With the central canal filled with the CSF, so this is the anterior part of the spinal cord, and this is the posterior or the dorsal part. So it resembles the S-shaped structure, that is the gray matter, and the projections of the dorsal and the ventral part, they appear like the horn of the sheep or the goat. So we use the word ventral horn. And this is the tubular or conical is the dorsal horn, or posterior horn we use the word horn. Now this is the gray matter, and it consists of small and large size of the neurons which are present over here. So we will take one by one. So one is the ventral horn. Then there is a lateral horn. And one is the dorsal horn, and one is the interneurons. So we'll take one by one. So ventral horn is broad, and it is also functionally called motor horn. If we say motor horn, it means M for M, same formula. The motor horn means the cells lying in the ventral horn, a axon or nerve fiber will be starting from here, and M for M, this nerve from the ventral horn will end into some muscle. So this is the M for M. So motor horn will end into the muscle. So that's why the ventral horn is functionally called motor horn. Various group of the cells are present. This is the medial, and this is the lateral, and in between two there is a central group of the ventral horn. So it is named as the ventromedial. This is ventrolateral, and this is the central group of the neurons of the ventral horn. The lateral horn is also present, which is very small. But this lateral horn is only present in the thoracic and the sacral region. And we know the little horn functionally correspond to the thoracic and lumbar region, the sympathetic outflow, and the sacral region is the parasympathetic outflow. So whenever we say the sympathetic, it means the second word should come thoracolumbar. If we say parasympathetic, the second word should come craniosacral. It means the preganglionic sympathetic fibers, they start from the lateral horn of the thoracic and the lumbar region. They are not present in the cervical or the sacral region. Similarly, if we say parasympathetic, means craniosacral. It means the lateral horn is only present in the sacral region, which is parasympathetic in function. And it will be only visible when we cut the transverse section of the sacral part of the spinal cord. Then there is a dorsal horn. So dorsal horn or the posterior horn is conical. And it is also consist of various cells. Various group of the cells over them. So one cell which is present in the uppermost or at the cap region is called the supramarginal. Posterior group of the cells. So these cells, they are, as we know, sensory horn. Posterior horn is sensory in function. So posterior is also called sensory. And sensory means S for S. Means the nerve, they start from the S, means skin. The dermis of the skin. And this sensory nerve will come and give the sensations to the posterior horn with a one dorsal root ganglion attached to every 31 pairs of the posterior or sensory nerve. So this is supramarginal posterior group of the neurons. Just below it, there is another group of the posterior horn cells, which is called substantia gelatinosa. Cells, and functionally these cells, they are inhibitory in function, or they modify the pain sensations. Just below it, there is another group of the posterior horn cells, which is called the nucleus proprius. This nucleus proprius is concerned with the general sensations of the body, which come from the skin, that is pain, temperature, pressure, and touch. All these four modalities of the sensory, starting from the skin, they all come and they relay in the nucleus proprius. Another group of the nucleus is present here in the deep part of the posterior horn is the Clarke's group of the posterior horn cells, and it has crossed to the opposite side also, and they interconnect both the sides of the posterior horn, and they are also concerned with the pain sensations. So this is how we study the various group of the cells in the posterior and the ventral horn. And beside this, there is also present medial and the lateral group of the interneurons also. So this is the interneuron group, that is the fourth group. It is divided into medial and lateral part. So two groups are visible, the interneurons. So these interneurons, they have got widespread connection both with the dorsal horn as well as with the ventral horn, and they are responsible for the various reflex arc system of the spinal cord, which are very, very essential in some of the superficial and the deep reflexes concerned in the human body. So this is how we study the gray matter as a whole in the form of the different nuclear groups present both in the ventral as well as in the dorsal horn. Now, after finishing with the various groups of the gray matter, there are also present interconnections. They are called the gray commissures, anterior as well as the posterior commissures. So they cross the midline and they connect the gray matter of the spinal cord of the right side with the left side. So they are called commissures. The ventral or the anterior one, and while the dorsal and the posterior one. So this is all about the gray matter of the spinal cord, and the next time we will take the white matter which is present around it, and the white matter present around it is having three parts: the posterior column, this whole of this white matter is called the lateral column, and this one is the anterior white column. So these white columns means they are bundles and bundles of the axons or the nerve fibers. Some are ascending and some are descending. So you will take one by one every part of the white matter in the next class. Thank you.